Sclerotherapy is a minimally invasive procedure performed to reduce the symptoms and improve the appearance of varicose and spider veins. Sclerotherapy involves the injection of a chemical solution into the affected veins, causing them to collapse and be reabsorbed by the body over time. Varicose veins are enlarged, twisted superficial veins, veins that are located just beneath the skin surface. Varicose veins can occur in any part of the body, but are most commonly found in the legs. These veins are flesh-colored or blue and can cause pain, swelling, and cramping. They are treated for both cosmetic purposes and for symptom relief. Varicose veins can be a symptom of an underlying medical condition and should be discussed with your primary doctor before initiating any treatment. Spider veins are small, damaged, superficial veins that are most commonly located on the legs or face. Typically blue, red, or purple, these thread-like veins often resemble a spider's web. Spider veins are generally closer to the skin's surface than varicose veins and do not often cause pain. Spider veins are typically treated for cosmetic purposes. Both varicose and spider veins are caused by problems with the way the blood flows through the veins. The circulatory system is made up of a network of blood vessels called arteries and veins. Arteries carry oxygenated blood from the heart to the rest of the body, while veins transport blood from the body back to the heart and lungs. Veins have one-way valves to prevent blood from flowing backward as it travels toward the heart. Veins in the legs are subject to large amounts of pressure, as they must work harder to carry blood upward to the heart against the force of gravity. This pressure, known as venous hypertension, can cause the valves in the veins of the legs to weaken and leak blood backward, which exerts pressure on the walls of the affected veins, causing them to stretch and twist. This result is the formation of varicose or spider veins. Factors such as obesity, pregnancy, hormonal changes, and prolonged sitting or standing can increase the risk of varicose and spider veins. Prior to sclerotherapy, you will have a consultation during which your provider will examine your veins and discuss your treatment goals. Sclerotherapy treatments typically last between 15 and 45 minutes, depending upon the size of the treatment area and the number of veins being treated. Typically, anesthesia is not required. The treatment area will be cleansed. Using a fine needle, your provider will inject a chemical solution called a sclerosing agent into the targeted veins. Depending upon its size, a single vein may need to be injected at several intervals. You may experience slight stinging as the solution is injected into the vein. The sclerosing agent works by irritating the lining of the vein, causing the walls of the vein to swell, stick together, and collapse. This closes the vein and stops the flow of blood. In the following weeks, the treated veins are absorbed by the body and fade in appearance. It's uncommon to experience serious complications from sclerotherapy. Potential risks may include infection, bruising, swelling, discoloration at the injection site, hardening of the treated veins, and allergic reaction. Sclerotherapy is an outpatient procedure, and you will be able to return home the same day and resume normal activities. In order to maintain pressure on the treated veins, you may be advised to wear compression stockings for up to 4 weeks following sclerotherapy. You should notice an improvement in the appearance of spider veins and smaller varicose veins in 3 to 6 weeks following sclerotherapy, while it may take 3 to 4 months for larger veins to respond to treatment. In order to achieve the desired results, most patients require multiple treatments, spaced approximately 4 to 6 weeks apart. While sclerotherapy will not prevent the formation of new varicose or spider veins, most individuals experience significant improvement in the appearance of treated veins following the procedure.